Discover PostgreSQL with Railsware Academy. Learn how to import CSV files to Postgres in just a few clicks. Hello everyone, and welcome to Railsware Academy. Today we will learn how to use PostgreSQL. This is a free and open source software. It works together with pgAdmin. This is a database management tool that simplifies our work. After watching this video, you will learn how to create servers, databases, schemas, and tables in Postgres, as well as see how we can import CSV files. We will first need to install PostgreSQL. For this, you can use a link in the video description or in our practice sheet. PostgreSQL installation is different for Windows, macOS, and Linux. In this video, I will present how to install PostgreSQL on Mac. If you want to skip this section, use timestamps in the video description to move right to a topic you are interested in. Go to the PostgreSQL website and click on Downloads. Download the needed file. We select the latest version. Open the file on your computer. For Mac, you should move it to Applications. The installation starts. Once done, open the application. And the Postgres window opens. As you can see, PostgreSQL doesn't have any graphical interface included in a box. This is why we will need to install a database management tool called pgAdmin. You can find a link in the video description. Go to Download. I choose macOS, but you can select any other operating system you use. Get the latest version and download the installation file. Once done, open the file, read and agree to the terms of license. Also, don't forget to move pgAdmin to Applications. Find pgAdmin in Applications and open it. Even though this is a local application, a new window in the browser will open. Create a master password. It will be required for each login. In this new window, we have two panels. We're going to work with the left one. It represents the structure of our databases, schemas, tables, and other objects. If you want to learn more about pgAdmin, you can find some useful links, materials, and a quick start guide on the right panel. We will start with creating a server. Right-click on Server, Create, Server. Let's use Localhost. Localhost is a host name that refers to the current computer used to access it. This means that Postgres is now run on your machine, not remotely. In connections, state 127.0.0.1. This is the standard address for IPv4. Not to overwhelm you with technical details now, I have shared a link to the article where you can read more about the localhost in the video description. Click Save, and our databases will appear here. You might see other local databases in the list. Those are used by PostgreSQL itself. Please do not remove those, not to lose any important data on your computer. Now, we need to create a database. Right-click on Databases, Create a new database. Let's call it Recruitment. Remember to use lowercase letters for database and table names. These ones are case-sensitive in SQL queries. Click Save. In the database, you have many components. We're going to start with schemas. Schema is a collection of database objects that helps you organize those in logical groups and make them more manageable. It can also allow many users to use one database without interfering with each other. You can read a bit more about PostgreSQL schemas using a link in the video description. The full path to a table looks like this: database.schema.table. In case you refer to tables in the same database and schema, you can state the table name only. Here you can see a schema called public. It is created by default and includes all of the objects that do not have a different schema specified. Every new database contains a public schema. Let's open it. And here we see tables contained in this schema. As you remember, we want to upload our dataset from CSV. Let's start with creating a table, fields, selecting data types and constraints. Later, we will import our dataset from CSV into this table. PostgreSQL table structure should match the one in your CSV file. This is a requirement to make the import work, so be super attentive here. Right-click on Tables, Create Table. Let's give our table a name. Remember that the name should be written in lowercase. Let's call it Applicants. Now we go to Columns and click Plus here. State the names of your columns. It is better to copy those from the original file. My dataset is stored in a G-sheet, so I will copy the column names from there. Review the data before uploading the table. The formatting is very important for SQL. The numbers, like salary, for example, should not have any separators. Use a single format for dates. Also, for column names, use only lowercase letters. You can also use underscore for better readability. After reviewing the dataset, let's copy column names, select the correct data types and constraints for our fields in PostgreSQL table. So we have applicant ID, the data type is numeric, and it should not be null, and this is a primary key. Position. We select numeric here, as I have position indexes in my table. If later on I want to join two tables on position index, both fields should have the same data type stated in PostgreSQL. I won't state the constraints here. Application date. The data type is date. Stage, text, status, text, recruiter, text, country, text, applicant name, text, and salary is numeric. Select additional constraints if needed. If you go to the SQL section, you will see the query you could use to create this exact table. Once you become an advanced SQL user, you will easily write those queries yourself. Since this tutorial is for beginners, we will skip the advanced part. Click Save. And we have just created a new table structure in PostgreSQL. It does not contain any data yet, though. We need to add it. For this, I would like to import a CSV. Let's go back to our G-sheet. As we have already reviewed the dataset and its structure exactly matches our PostgreSQL table structure, I will go to File, Download, in comma-separated values format, or CSV. Go back to pgAdmin. Right-click on the table, Import Export. First, switch to Import here, or otherwise, you will rewrite your original CSV file to what you have in the table now. Select the file from your computer. The format is CSV, encoding is UTF-8. We do have headers in the first row, so click Yes. And we need to state the delimiter used in our CSV. To check this, open your CSV file in a simple text editor. I use TextEdit for Mac or a simple Notepad for Windows. The data from CSV will be separated by semicolon or comma. I select the needed symbol from the menu. In the Columns section, make sure that all of the required fields are reflected there. Click OK. You will see the status pop-up window down here. We have successfully imported our data. Let's check it. Right-click on the table, Query Tool. Type a simple query. Select asterisk for all from applicants. Click Run. And yes, all of the data is here. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to click like and subscribe. Watch Railsware Academy SQL series to learn various SQL commands. See a few links on the end screen of this video. Railsware is a product studio. We have created Coupler.io, a tool to pull your data from various apps to Google Sheets. Click the link and try it today. Watch our SQL and Google Sheets tutorials to get the most out of automated data flows.